What up, YouTube? Salvador Brigman here. Welcome back to the Crowdfunding Demystified YouTube channel. On this channel, we get into crowdfunding in terms of how to launch a campaign, how to do well on Indiegogo, and specifically today, we're getting into some of the keys that go into a successful Indiegogo campaign. So you're trying to raise money on Indiegogo for a new product or a new project and you don't know where to get started, but in addition, you want to make sure that the campaign you launch is effective, that it actually raises funds. Today's tips are going to go through exactly that. You know, I have another awesome video out there going through some of the differences between Indiegogo and Kickstarter. I would recommend anyone out there who is new to crowdfunding to go and check out that YouTube video that I put out, because there are some differences when it comes to the actual Indiegogo crowdfunding platform and some of the crowdfunding websites that are out there that you can also use to raise funds. So go and check out that video comparing Indiegogo and Kickstarter. The first and most important part of any kind of Indiegogo campaign is the pitch video, because that's the first thing that people see when they come to your page. The pitch video is an opportunity, kind of like a movie trailer, if you will. It's a teaser to get people interested, to hook them, so they read through the rest of your campaign. They check out some of the perks and rewards that you're offering. That pitch video is the first thing that people come across, and it has to be emotionally evocative. The first key to success on Indiegogo is a killer pitch video. And again, I have some videos out there also on how to put together this actual video, the things that go into storytelling, how you actually will present a product, how do you arouse curiosity and interest, how do you get someone to want to buy something, basically, and how do you do that in video form? How does the human mind work, where we actually need to see many different angles of the product, many different frames, different B-roll shots in order to maintain our attention? The goal of the pitch video, number one, is to maintain attention. You want someone to watch this from the beginning to the end, to be in that prime state, to actually be interested in your perks and rewards. But number two, you also want to be communicating a promise or hooking them in some way where they're like, this sounds really cool, or I can totally see myself using this product, I want to learn a bit more, and then they go through the description of your campaign. The second tip comes into engineering success, and this is a key for any successful Indiegogo campaign. That is engineering success, or what I call the pre-launch. So the pre-launch is what allows you to rank well on Indiegogo, the actual Indiegogo marketplace or platform, if you will. How do you actually rank well and become a trending project? Well, in order for Indiegogo to feature you, just like any other marketplace like Amazon, you can't just announce a product. You also have to, on Amazon, have some great reviews. You have to have people buying the product in order to sort of get that trajectory going, get them to recommend your product to other people on Amazon. Same thing works with Indiegogo. You gotta have a pre-launch for your campaign where you're warming people up, you're gathering and building an email list, you're getting those social media accounts going. That pre-launch is what enables that instant funding of your project to get a little bit of that funding meter going, and then Indiegogo starts to suggest you in the category. Maybe they include you in a newsletter once you get to 100% funded, and that's when things can take off. It's not about just hitting your goal, it's surpassing it wildly and engineering this viral campaign. There's kind of an art to setting a goal, setting a fundraising goal, because that fundraising goal is not only the amount that you're seeking publicly, but it's also the amount that you have to hit if you want to start to get into those larger sums and actually surpass this thing and start to trend well on Indiegogo. And the thing that I tell my students is, you might be looking to raise $1 million or six figures or however much money, but my question is always, what is the minimum amount that you need in order to make this project a reality? If you're doing fixed funding, how much do you need in order for your minimum order quantity for this product? If you're doing flexible funding, what's the lowest goal that you can hit that also sort of conveys that confidence you can actually deliver on your promises and the product that you're saying? Now, my third key tip here for any successful crowdfunding campaign with Indiegogo, with Kickstarter, is to set a realistic goal. And here's why. If you set an unrealistic goal, let's just say you've never done a crowdfunding campaign before, you have no clout whatsoever, you don't have an email list, you have no pre-launch strategy, no marketing whatsoever, just kind of hoping that you're gonna launch this thing that's gonna go viral. The problem with that is, if you have a $100,000 goal and you are so far away from that goal, you've only raised, you know, 500 bucks or maybe even 1,000, people are gonna come to that page and they're gonna be like, oh, this thing is never gonna happen, or oh, this project does not look like it's doing pretty well, I'm not even gonna take the time to watch the video. However, If you have a campaign that maybe has a $25,000 goal and you've already hit that goal and now you're starting to raise more, people are like, what is this project? Like, I want to learn a little bit more. Like, this is already a successful campaign. I'm going to take the time to watch the video and take the time to check out some of the rewards. I'm going to learn a little bit more about it. By having a realistic goal, which you hit as soon as possible, or at least you get to in terms of the percentage wise, the 50% mark, the 70% mark, as soon as possible, you're going to rope in more people that might be interested in your project. It increases the overall social proof, it's called, for your campaign. The fourth tip that I see many entrepreneurs who have been on my podcast, people that I've spoken to, and also some of my coaching students, the way that they've sort of harnessed the power of Indiegogo is not just to use it for its fundraising capability. Don't get me wrong. You can raise money on Indiegogo. You can do a successful crowdfunding campaign. You can get that money that you need to finance maybe a minimum order quantity. But the bigger opportunity here, I think, is media exposure. It's making this thing a big event that people are checking out your project. People are writing about it. It's a media event. It almost like it has a little bit more hype to it, where if you're doing a product launch or announcing something new or a new offer, that's way more exciting than just kind of, you know, throwing up a product on your website or something and no one really hears about it. And it's really difficult to broadcast. With a crowdfunding campaign, it can turn into a media event. My fourth tip for having a successful Indiegogo campaign is to plan a media strategy. Now, not every campaign necessarily has to have a media strategy. Not everyone is looking for media attention. Not everyone wants to be the center of attention. This is for those people out there that are trying to grow a brand. You're trying to grow a brand either around yourself, you're trying to grow a brand around a particular product. Maybe you're going to be releasing more products in the future. You want to have a mega brand out there. And if you do, then you can do things like you can court influencers, you can do press releases, you can reach out to journalists, you can share that story. And in addition, the events that are unfolding, that you now just got to 70% of your goal, you now just hit your goal, now it's surpassed by 2x. It's an exciting media event, and it actually allows people to then want to write about you because there's a built-in audience for your project. If you have 1,000 backers, that's 1,000 people that are going to check out their new media story. What a reporter wants is they want a story that has an audience and that also is going to garner attention. They want to write about a sure thing. They don't want to write about some new product that you announced on your own website, something that has no traction, that has no buyers, no sales, no proven aspect behind it. When they see that this project is going viral on social media, when they see that people are buying into this, they see the funding meter going up and up and up, that creates a media story, and that is something they want to write about. The fifth tip that I see successful entrepreneurs doing and business owners doing is that they're really good at identifying what they're good at and what they're not good at. And typically, they might be good on the manufacturing side, on the design side, maybe figuring out the supply chain, but they don't know marketing. Or maybe they're really good at marketing, but they need a little bit of help when it comes to the prototyping of their product. You have to understand what are your strengths and your skill sets and your temperament, and where do you need help. All successful business owners are able to assemble a team of people around them that are invested in their success and that want to work hard to see this vision accomplished, to see this vision come into reality. Not only is a team good from like a labor distribution standpoint, from a, if you want to create something bigger than yourself, you need a team standpoint, but it's also great because the more people you have invested in your campaign, the more people are going to check it out. You know, they're going to be sharing it on their own social channels, they're going to have their friends of friends checking it out. The bigger your team and the more people invest in your project, the more likely it is to be successful. My fifth tip here is build a team. Think about it this way. Like, let's just say we're playing soccer and you're like an all-star, best in the world soccer player and you're playing against me. Of course, you're probably going to win when we're playing soccer. Now, I was pretty good when I was younger, but when it comes to playing a professional soccer player, I'm probably going to lose against them. But now, let's just say that it's me and someone else versus that soccer player. Well, probably still gonna lose, honestly. They probably can maneuver the ball really well. I mean, they can run faster. What if it's me and 5 other people? What if it's me and 10 other people? The more people that you add to your team, you don't necessarily have to be the best soccer player in the world, but just by virtue of having people invest in your success, being willing to work with you, you outnumber them. This is exactly why we see some campaigns that look so incredibly polished, like amazing videos, incredible campaign design, great marketing, all these different things. One person is not doing all of that. The reason why you're able to have this incredible result is because you have a team of people working behind the scenes in order to make that result happen. So teams of people kind of make it so that you don't have to do everything yourself. You can actually distribute the labor, but also you have lots of talented people working together. And in that way, you can create something incredible that one single person never could do themselves. If you'd like to learn a little bit more about what goes into an effective crowdfunding campaign, go and check out the link down below. I have the Udemy course, the Kickstarter launch formula, episode, which will walk you through some of the basic tenets when it comes to putting together a successful crowdfunding campaign. I hope you liked this video. I'm also available for a coaching session if you'd like to talk one-on-one with me. I will include that link down below. But my name is Salvador Brigman, and I will see you next time.